Is this PDF is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is the numerical we were seeing. Here the random variable Z is used. This is for the normalized Gaussian variable. Here the mean is 0 and the variance is 1. Whatever they are given, here the mean is 0 and variance is 1. We have to find the probability of Z where it lies between minus 0.505 and 1.456. Hope you have seen the table. Have you seen that table which I have shared? The probability table for normalized Gaussian random variable. Have you seen that? Please do reply. This is the table I have shared with you. This is the table I have shared. Okay, from this only we have to find the phi value. This is the this equation we have to use. That is, here this probability it lies between minus 0.505 and 1.456. So here we can write it as phi of this x2. Here we can take it as x2, that is 1.456, and minus phi of this value. This is the x1 value. We used to write f of x2 minus f of x1. Instead of that, we can write in terms of phi, that is phi of 1.456 minus phi of this minus 0.505. This we have to find out using that table. Here first value we take it as phi of 1.456. Here if we see in the table, we have this step by step, we can see here 1.4 value where it is, we will first see it. 1.456 is the value we have to find out. So in the first column, this is the Z variable. Here we have to see where is 1.4. Here is 1.4 value. This is the 1.4 value. And here this other columns are the second decimal point values. Here if you see, this is for 1.40 value. And this is for 1.41 value. And this next one is for 4.12 value. So like that, first we want 1.456. So here 1.4 value we have, and next is 4.5 value we want. So here in the second decimal, we have to see where is the 5 value, that is 0.05. Here 1.4 plus 0.05 will become 1.45. So that column we have to see. Here it is 1.41, 1.42, 1.43, 1.44, and this is the 1.45 value. This is for 1.45, but we have to find 1.456. So we don't have that third decimal here. Here till only till two decimal places we have in this table. So for that value, we have to take the interpolation formula wherein we take the two values, that is 1.45 and 1.46, the next value. Here in between these two values, we have our value, that is 1.456. We have in between these two values. So for that, we have to write this formula. This is the interpolation formula. Wait a second. Okay, this is the interpolation formula wherein this is the x value whichever we want to find out. Here in this phi of 1.456, here this is the x value we want to find out. And in the table we have only values for 1.45 and 1.46. So those values we have to take. In between these two values we have this value. So x1 we take it as 1.45 and the next value is 1.46. So whatever the values are there for 1.45 and 1.46, we have to take it as y1 and y2. Here for 1.45, we have this value. For 1.4, wait a second. So 1.45, we have this value, that is 0.9251. And for the next value, this will be y1, that is 0.9251. This is y1 we have taken. And next value is 1.46, that is this value. Here it is 0.9265. So those two values we have to take it as y1 and y2. So here it is 0.9265 y1 value, and the next for 1.46 we have 0.9279. So these two values we have to substitute it here. Here this is the formula to find out this y value. Here this y2 is 9279 and y1 is 0.9265 and x2 is 1.46 and x1 is 1.45, and x value is the one which we need to find out. Here x value is 1.456 minus this x1 value, that is 1.45, plus this y1 value. This is the formula you have to remember. And here this we have up to 3 decimal places, but in the table we have only 2 decimal places. So in between these two values we have this value, that is 1.456 is in between 1.45 and 1.46. So these two value we have to take it as x1 and x2, and the value from the table for this 1.45 is 0.9265, and for x2 we have 0.9279. So in this formula you have to substitute all these values, that is x1, x2, y1, y2 and x value. If you substitute it here, this is the equation you get. This equation you have to solve it. Just you have to subtract these both, divide this and subtract here, and multiply these two values, and then you just add this value. So you will get this 0.9273. This is for the 1.456. So just take down this. You also solve it without seeing later. Once again, you just see the table and solve this. Now you just take down this solution. This formula is very important. This first you have to note down. Y is equal to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 into x minus x1 plus y1. Here we have this 1.456. After decimal we have 3 values, but in the table up to 2 decimal values they have given the values for these. So in between these two values we have this 1.456. So we have to take both the values and use this interpolation formula. Just substitute all these values whichever you get, and if you solve this you will get 0.9273. So now this first value we have found out, phi of 1.456 is 0.9273. Just take down this, later on we will see this part. After finding this you have to just subtract the values, then you will get the probability of this z value. This problem you solve it once again using that table. You only see the values from the table and solve this. Now just take down this solution. You just compare your solution with this. Next we have to see phi of minus 0.505. Here in this table we have only positive values, but the next one we have to solve it for negative. So for that what we have to do, we will see. In previous classes, we have seen like probability of x greater than 2. We used to write it as 1 minus probability of x less than or equal to 2. So you have to just subtract that lesser value from 1. Here also we have to use it as 1 minus phi of the positive value. This equation we can write it as phi of 1 minus phi of 0.505. Here it is minus. So phi of minus 0.505 is equal to 1 minus phi of 0.505. Then for that value we have to see in the table and then subtract it from 1. So next we will see that this we can write it as, here it is in the minus sign, but in the table we have only positives, so we can write it as 1 minus phi of 0.505. so this value we have to find out from the table and then we have to substitute it here. So 1 minus that value, then we will get this phi of minus 0.505. Here also this is 3 decimal points, that is 0.505. Here in the table we have up to 2 decimal points, so we have to take 2 values, that is 0.50 and 0.51. In between these 2 values we have this value. From the table if we see 0.50, here it is 0.5. From this first column we have to see where is the value, here it is 0.5. So in this column here this is 0.5 and we need 0.505, but here we can take it as 0.50. First we have to take x1 as 0.50, this is 0.50, and next one we have to take it as 0.51. So here if we see, here it is 0.5 and here it is 0.50, and this is 0.501 value. Here this column if you see it is 2 decimal points, here it is 0.50 and this is for 0.51. So in between these 2 values we have 0.505. So first x1 value is 0.50, for that we have 0.6915, and next one is x2, that is 0.51, then y2 value we have it as 0.6950. So if we substitute in the same equation, we have to substitute. Here it is, x1 is 0.50, x2 is 0.51 and y1 is 0.6915 and y2 is 0.6950. So if you substitute all these things, that is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 into x minus x1 plus y1. If you substitute, you will get this y value as 0.6932. This is for phi of 0.505, that is 0.6932, but you want in the negative value. So here you have to subtract this value from 1. Here you have to substitute this value. Here this value is 0.6932. So here you have to write 1 minus 0.6932, which is 0.3068. So now you know both these values. Here the first value, that is phi of 1.456, you have found out it as 0.9273, and this we have it as 0.3068. You have to subtract, then you get the probability of z as 0.6205. So this is the solution. You just take down this. Just write down here, this is for negative, so you have to take it as 1 minus phi of 0.505. this value you have to check in the table. Here up to 2 decimal points we have these 2 values. In between these 2 values we can find 0.505. so we have to take x1 as 0.50, x2 as 0.51, and for this we have the value as 0.6915 and for y2 is 0.6950. So we have to substitute in this formula, that is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 into x minus x1 plus y1. In this formula, you have to substitute all these values. Then you will get y as 0.6932, which is nothing but phi of 0.505, that is 0.6932. Then for the negative phi, that is phi of minus 0.505, we have to subtract that value from 1. It is 1 minus 0.6932. So you will get it as 0.3068. So just you have to substitute in this equation, that is phi of 1.456 minus phi of minus 0.505. Now you know both these values. So just substitute and you will get 0.6205 as the answer. So this is the probability of Z, which lies between 0.505 and 1.456. This is the value. You just note down this. In these kind of problems, you have to just remember this formula, and according to the value they are given, you have to choose where you have to where this value lies, in between which value the solution you have to find out, that you have to see and substitute in this equation. If negative is given, you have to do 1 minus that negative value. So if you are done, we will next move to the next problem. Next we will see, and this is the table. I'll give you one more problem. This is for assignment. Here this is the random variable Z is normalized Gaussian. Here also the mean is 0 and the variance is 1. Here you have to find the probability of Z, which lies between minus 1.003 and 2.392. So this is the problem. You have to do it for assignment. Just take down this. Similar kind of problem. Here also first you have to solve for this, and this is negative, so you have to take 1 minus this value from this. Using this table you have to solve. I have already shared you this, so just take it as assignment and do. The random variable Z is normalized Gaussian, that is its mean is 0 and variance is 1. Find the probability of Z, which lies between minus 1.003 and 2.392. First you have to just take it as phi of 2.392 minus phi of minus 1.003. Then first you have to solve for this, and next you can take this as 1 minus phi of 1.003 and solve for phi of 1.003 and subtract it from 1, and then substitute both the values here. That will be the solution for probability of Z. So next we will see another problem. Here it is, little different. Take down this. The random variable z is normalized Gaussian. It is known that f z of a, here they have given the value itself. We have to find this a value. Till now we found out phi of x value, some x they have given, phi of x value, what will be that, we have found out. Now we have to find that x value itself. Here they have taken it as a. So just take down this. Here they have given fz of a as 0.6340. In the table we have to check where this value is and then we have to solve. Here we can take the inverse of this to find the a value. Here we have to find out the constant a value, that if fz inverse of 0.6340. Here we can replace this with the phi also, phi inverse of 0.6340. So first we have to check in the table where this value is, that is 0.6340. So if we check in the table, 0.6340, here it is 0.63 value, 0.6340 we want, but here it is 0.6331, and next value if we see, here it is 0.6368. So in between these two values, we have 0.6340, yeah, correct. So in between these two, that is 0.6340 is in between these two values. So if we see here in the row, it is 0.3. And if we see this column, that is 0.34, and here it is 0.35. So in between these two values, that is 0.34 and 0.35, we have 0.6340 value. So these we have to take it as x1, that is 0.34, we have to take it as x1, and 0.35 we have to take it as x2, and this value we have to take it as y1 for 0.34. For 0.34 we have value of y1 as 0.6331. And for this, that is x2, that is 0.35, we have y2 as 0.6368. So using that x1, x2, y1, y2, we have to find out that a value. Here if you see, here x1 is 0.34 and x2 is 0.35. And the value for that is 0.6331. And here for 0.35, the value is 0.6368, and this is the value we have to find out. So here it is y is equal to 0.6340. So here we have to find this x value. So just that interpolation formula is rearranged in terms of x value. Here it was y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1, but here it is reversed, that is x2 minus x1 divided by y2 minus y1 into y minus y1 plus x1. So if we want the inverse, we have to use this formula and then we have to substitute these values, that is x2, x1, y2, y1, and this is the y value. Here it is 0.6340. So just note down this formula. When we have to find the inverse, that interpolation formula is just rearranged in terms of x. Here it will be x2 minus x1 divided by y2 minus y1 into y minus y1 plus x1. Here it used to be y here. But here this is rearranged and written in this way. So we can find this constant by using this inverse. So just substitute all these values. X2 value is 0.35. x1 is 0.34, y2 is 6368, and y1 is 6331. and this y value is 0.6340 and y1 is 0.6331 and this x1 value is 0.34. So x value you get it as 0.3424. So that is nothing but the constant. Here this is for the phi inverse of 0.6340. We get it as 0.3424. That is the value for A. So this is the solution. Just take down this. From the table, you have to check where this value is. We have two values. Here it is 0.6331 and 0.6368. In between these two values, we have 0.6340. So we have to consider both the values, that is 0.34 and 0.35, and then solve substituting in this equation. Then you will get the A value as 0.3424. Just note down this solution. This equation is also important. One more I had given it for assignment, that also you solve. And today whichever I have solved, those also you check it from the table. You verify the answers. Have you all understood how to check from that table?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So next we will solve another problem. Here the problem is based on Laplace random variable. So here they have given the constant B value as 2 and calculate the probability of x which lies between 0.28 and minus 0.37. So this is the probability we have to find out using the Laplace random variable model. So you all know what is the formula for Laplace random variable. This is the CDF value. That is, for x greater than or equal to 0, we have it as 1 minus 1 by 2 e raised to minus bx, and for the x value less than 0, we have it as 1 by 2 e raised to bx. So here they have given this b value. This b value is given and we have to find the probability of x from minus 0.37 to 0.28. So this equation you already know, and in this we have to find this probability. So we can write this in terms of CDF as fx of x2, here x2 is 0.28, minus fx of x1, here x1 is minus 0.37. So here for this value, we have it as 1 minus 1 by 2 e raised to minus, here b value is 2 and here the x value is 0.28. Here this is the positive values, that is 0.28, for this is positive value, so x greater than or equal to 0, we have this value. So in this we have to substitute the b value and this is the x, that is 0.28. So here if you substitute, here it is 1 minus 1 by 2 e raised to minus b value is 2, here it is 2 and this is the x value, that is 0.28. And for this value, here it is negative, that is x less than 0, we have this equation. Here it is 1 by 2 e raised to b value is 2 and x value is minus 0.37. If you substitute that and using the calculator, you have to take this e value. You get it as 0.5712 here and this value is 0.4. 4771. So if you solve this, here it will be 1 minus 0.2856, and this is -0.2385. So the probability of x, you get it as 0.4759. This is the solution for probability of x, which lies between 0.37, that is -0.37, and 0.28. Okay, so just take down this solution. This numerical also you take. Here it is, b is equal to 2 they have given, and we have to find the probability of x, which lies between -0.37 and 0.28. Here, using Laplace random variable, they have only told. So here, this you can write in terms of CDF, that is fx of x2. Here this is x2, and minus fx of x1, this is x1. So for that, you have to take this CDF equation, fx of x, for x values greater than or equal to 0, we have it as 1 minus 1 by 2 e raised to minus bx. And for x values less than 0, we have it as 1 by 2 e raised to bx. So here 1 is positive value. So for that we have to use this equation. And the other one is negative value. For that we have to use this equation. In this we have to substitute the b value, whatever they have given. And here the x value will be that particular value. For this positive, we have 0.28. And for this negative, we have -0.37. If you just substitute in this, and using calculator, you have to calculate this e raised to that value and substitute in this equation. Here you have just substituted for both these. For x greater than or equal to 0, this is the formula, and this is for x less than 0.
Ma'am, how to take the b value?
What to take?
How to take the b value?
Here in this equation, b value they have already given in the problem only. In this question only they have given this b value. Okay.
Okay.
This constant b value they have given in the question itself. Just this x value you have to take from this. Just substitute this b value here. And this will be x for positive. This is the value. And for this negative we have this value. After substituting, you get the probability value as 0.4759. Just verify that answer. You have to remember that random variable, that is Laplace, here they have asked. They can ask any other random variable. You have to just remember the PDF and CDF values and substitute accordingly. So almost we are end of this module. Few more numericals are there, 2 to 3 numericals. After that this module will be over. If you have any doubts regarding this module 1, you can ask me later. You also solve more numericals from the textbook and solve all the derivations, everything. In 1 or 2 days, I'll give the assignment also for this module. So next problem we will see. Here it is the discrete random variable. Given the discrete random variable x, where they have given this PDF, that is fx of x. They have given in terms of this delta or impulse function. Here this is the equation they have given, 0.25 delta x plus 0.25 delta x minus 1 plus 0.25 delta x minus 2 and plus 0.25 delta x minus 3. This formula you already know this. Here these will be the probability values, that is probability into delta of x minus xi value, that you have already seen. This is the formula they have given, and they have given the probability values here. Here all the probabilities are equal, that is 0.25, and they have asked for the event B, where B is greater than 0. We have to find the PDF and CDF conditioned by B. Here the event B is used where B is greater than x, B is equal to x greater than 0. Here the x values are from 0 and here the x is 1, here x is 2 and here the x is 3. Here they have given 4 values from 0 to 4, 0 to 3 values they have given, and here the probability of B is x greater than 0. Here we have to find the PDF and CDF conditioned by this event. This is the event B they have given, and conditioned, here we have to use the conditioned random variable formula. That is fx conditioned by B, we have this formula. That is fx of x divided by probability of B. Here this fx of x they have already given. This is the equation they have given. This is fx of x they have given. We have to find the probability of B here. To find the probability of B, they have given this x greater than 0. So if we take this x greater than 0, then the probability of x will be values from x equal to 1 to 3. Because greater than 0 they have asked, not greater than or equal to. They have asked only for x values greater than 0. So this value we have to cancel, and only from x is equal to 1, x is equal to 2 and x is equal to 3, those three probability values we have to take. In this equation these are the probability values, that is 0.25. We have already seen this equation of delta and the unit step function. In that, if you compare it, here these are the probability values. So from probability x is equal to 1, we have 0.25. here it is the first value, that is probability of x is equal to 1, and next this is for the probability of x is equal to 2, and this is for probability of x is equal to 3. So these are the three values we have to consider. Here we have all the equal probabilities, so it will be 0.25 plus 0.25 plus 0.25. here the probability of B is 0.75. so this is the probability for B. You just take down this. We have to find the PDF for x conditioned by B. This is the formula, that is fx of x divided by the probability of B. So first we have to find the probability of B, where they have given the condition for x as greater than 0. Here they have given the probability values for x is equal to 0, for x is equal to 1, for x is equal to 2, for x is equal to 3. But here the probability of B is x greater than 0. So we have to take it from probability of x is equal to 1, then x is equal to 2 and x is equal to 3. Here it is discrete random variable. So just we have to do the summation for all these. So these are the three probability values we have, and probability of B will be 0.75. Here if you substitute the probability of B and fx of x value, they have already given. This is the equation. So just substitute it here. So this is fx of x divided by probability of b. Here x is greater than 0. They have given the condition. So this is the fx of value, that is 0.25 delta of x minus 1. Here it is for x greater than 0 only. So we have to just cancel this first term. This we must not consider. This I have cancelled it. Here it is for x greater than 0. So from 1 to 3 we have to take. So it is 0.25 delta x minus 1. Next is 0.25 delta x minus 2. And next is 0.25 delta x minus 3. And this is the probability of B we have calculated divided by 0.75. So the equation of this conditioned PDF becomes 1 by 3. Here if you just cancel this, here it is. If you just separate this, it is 0.25 delta x minus 1 divided by 0.75. Here also 0.25 divided by 0.75 into delta x minus 3. If you just separately divide this point by 0.75, you get it as 1 by 3. 1 by 3 delta x minus 1. Here also it is 1 by 3 delta x minus 2 and 1 by 3 delta x minus 3. So this is the conditioned PDF. In this formula, you have to just substitute fx of x value and probability of b. Here they are given for x greater than 0. So the first term here given will be not considered. Here also same thing. So we have to consider the probability from x is equal to 1 to 3. If you substitute and cancel this, you will get 1 by 3. Delta x minus 1 plus 1 by 3 delta x minus 2 plus 1 by 3 delta x minus 3. So for CDF, you have to just take the integration. So integration of delta function will be, what will be integration of delta function? Integration of delta function. Tell me, what is the integration of delta function?
Unit function.
Okay, correct. So here we have to just integrate this conditioned PDF. Here they have given it from 1 to 3. Here this is constant. If you just integrate, here also it is from 1 to 3. Just this delta function is replaced by unit step function. That is only the difference for this PDF and CDF equation. Here this is constant, so keep it as it is. And integration, here it will be unit step. So take down this solution. Next numerical is also similar. You take it as assignment. Here they have given the discrete random variable x and here they have given the fx of x value. Here also it is given in terms of delta function. And here the event b is given as greater than 1. X greater than 1. Here also you have to find the PDF and CDF conditioned by the event B. Here the event B is given as greater than 1, x greater than 1. First you have to find the probability of B and then you have to substitute in fx of fx of x conditioned by B. You have to substitute fx of x value and probability of B value. And for CDF, you have to just integrate There the equation remains same, constants will be kept as it is, and integration of delta function will become the unit step function. Take down this as assignment. Fx of x value, PDF they have given, and the event B, they have given the condition x as greater than 1, and you have to find out the PDF and CDF conditioned by event B. You already know the CDF and PDF equations for conditioned random variable. First you find out the PDF, conditioned PDF, that is fx by B of x. You have to substitute fx of x value and probability of B value. Here they have given four values. Here x is equal to 0, x is equal to 1, x is equal to 2, and x is equal to 3. Here the probability values are different, that is 0.37, 0.16, 0.29, and 0.18. Substitute in the equations and find out. Next, this is for uniform distribution problem. We will see this in the next class. You just do those two assignment problems. One is for the conditioned PDF and CDF, and another one for the Gaussian distribution. From the table you have to see and do that. I have shared you that table. From that table you just see and do the assignment. Okay, this we will see in the next class. This is for the normal uniform distribution. Here f of x for uniform distribution will be fx of x 1 by x2 minus x1, or you can take it as b minus a, 1 by b minus a or x2 minus x1, where x value will be in between x1 and x2 and 0 otherwise. Here also you have to find the conditioned PDF mean value and conditioned variance. So I will see this in the next class. If you have any doubts regarding this module, you can ask, or later you can just text me or call me, anything is fine. You have to solve numericals from that textbook whichever I have shared. From Williams only most of the problems will be asked in the exam. So you just try to solve all the numericals from Richard Williams. I have shared that textbook only for first module. So for all those exercise problems and all, you just go through that. You have to practice all the derivations. Okay.